Namaste, I'm Mini and welcome to my channel Food Atomic. Today we are making sticky sesame cauliflower. It's vegan and gluten-free. This mouth-watering recipe is prepared by frying or baking the battered cauliflower and then mixing it with spicy, sweet, tangy and flavorful sauce. If you're new here, I make easy vegan recipes with step-by-step instructions, and if you'd like to see more vegan videos, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon. Let's get started. Step number 1. Take one medium-sized cauliflower. I have sliced it into medium florets and then washed it thoroughly and soaked in hot water with some turmeric and salt for 20 minutes. This step is optional, but I like to do it as it softens the cauliflower as well as to make sure that there are no worms in it. Step number 2. Let's prepare the batter for the cauliflower. To a bowl, take around 200 grams of chickpeas or gram flour. Add 2 tablespoons of cornstarch, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, pinch of turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon of salt or salt as per taste, 1.5 teaspoon of garlic powder. Mix the dry ingredients. If you see chunks of spice or flour, make sure to break them. Once mixed, add water to dry ingredients gradually and in small quantities. We are going to prepare a running or smooth batter. So, till you get to this consistency, keep on adding the water little by little. Once the batter is ready, add the cauliflower florets to the bowl. Don't add all of them at once. Add like 1/3 or 1/2 of it so it's easier to mix and coat them. And once they are coated perfectly, take them out and coat the rest. Once you finish coating all the cauliflower florets, it's time to fry them. You can bake them or air fry them as well. Step number 3. Heat oil in a pan. As the oil gets really hot, switch the heat to medium and then add the cauliflower florets to it one by one. The reason we don't add them together is because they will stick to each other and won't get crispy from all the sides properly. Plus, it's easier to work on them when they are added separately. Make sure that the heat is set to medium so the florets get cooked evenly from the inside as well as from the outside. Once the florets get crispy, take them out of the pan. Try to taste the biggest floret to see if it is cooked properly or not. Also, you can always cook just one of the cauliflower floret and do a taste test and adjust the spices or the salt level in the remaining one before frying them. I will admit that I ended up eating a lot of them while frying as they are on point with taste and so irresistible. Step number 4. It's time to prepare the sauce. Add 2 tablespoons of sesame oil to a pan. Then add 5 cloves of finely chopped garlic. Make sure the heat is set to low so the garlic doesn't burn. Cook it for 2 minutes. Then add 5 tablespoons of gluten-free soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of red wine vinegar, 2 tablespoons of agave syrup, 3 tablespoons of sriracha. If you don't have sriracha, replace it with a spicy sauce, 2 tablespoons of ketchup. Now mix everything. Remember, we are cooking it over low heat. Let it cook for 2 to 3 minutes and meanwhile we will prepare the cornstarch slurry. Add 2 tablespoons of cornstarch to a bowl. Then add 4 to 5 tablespoons of water and mix everything till the cornstarch gets completely dissolved in water. We use cornstarch to thicken the sauce. As you can see, even though the heat is set to low, the sauce is slightly boiling. Add the cornstarch slurry to it. Now mix it till it's nicely incorporated. You will start to notice that the sauce is thickening up. Let it cook for 2 minutes and then mix again. You can add some water if you want to adjust the thickness, but for the sticky sesame cauliflower, this is a perfect consistency. At this point, switch off the heat and add the better fried cauliflower florets to the pan. Mix till all the florets are evenly coated with the sauce. Look at that. It already smells amazing and looks so good. For the final touch, sprinkle some sesame seeds on top of it, followed by some spring onion greens or chives. Give it a mix again and serve hot. You can eat this like a starter, or this goes really well with some fried rice or even plain noodles. For the final finish, I'm sprinkling some more sesame seeds, both white and black, followed by some more chives. This recipe is so quick to prepare and will check all the right boxes on the taste test. It is one of my favorite appetizers, as it's the most delicious food on the planet. So, if you like today's recipe, do give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel Food Atomic. As usual, I have listed all the equipment and ingredients I use in the description section. You can find the written recipe of this video on my website foodatomic.com. Also, check out this delicious stuffed potato cake recipe. And if you're looking for more vegan videos, you would definitely love this vegan playlist right here. That's all for today, guys. I'll be back soon with another interesting vegan recipe. Until then, bye.